Hi. So I have created the first political protest in a form on NFT. It is a video where I destroy a Nazi monument created by the contemporary Lithuanian government in Lithuania. So the achievement is in uploading that video on blockchain and creating the first NFT dedicated to this kind of political protest, like real life political protests. Let's take a look.
Stanislovas Tomas, aš esu profesorius advokatas, ką tik sudaužiau atminjo su kūju. Fiktyviškai. The national hero in Lithuania.
So, who was Jonas Noreika and why did he deserve the strikes by my sledgehammer? He was appointed to the position of a governor of northern Lithuania by the Lithuanian government of 1941. So, in 1941, Adolf Hitler attacks the Soviet Union during the World War II and occupies Lithuania. At that territory, Adolf Hitler creates a puppet government, which is called Government of Lithuania, but, you know, it's a Nazi government. So that puppet Nazi government appoints Jonas Noreika to the position of the governor of northern Lithuania. And as a governor of northern Lithuania, he is responsible for murdering 14,500 Jews from 1941 to 1943. The contemporary Lithuanian government justifies murdering 14,500 Jews by Jonas Noreika with the fact that he was perhaps forced by Germans. It was a German order to do that, so he was killing people because he was executing an order. I don't think that this is a justification. This was a justification that was rejected on many times by different international tribunals. However, there are also proofs of an internal desire of Jonas Noreika to murder Jews. For instance, he prepared a business plan for the Skaistgiris death camp. So when you prepare a business plan, it is a proof that you want this business to prosper, you know. So he asked 118,660 rubles from the Lithuanian Nazi government in order to establish a death camp. And he explained that the death camp would bring a huge profit and the government would get its money back. This is called business plan. And for me, this business plan is the best example that he actually desired to murder all those Jews. I have gotten a huge reaction from the Lithuanian political establishment. First of all, the president of Lithuania, Gitanas Nausėda, made a statement that the Nazi plaque had to be re-established. The prime minister, Giedrius Skvernelis, made a statement that the plaque had to be re-established. The neo-Nazi mayor of Vilnius, Remigius Šimašius, made a statement that my name had to be forgotten in the same manner as the name of Herostratus, who destroyed the temple of Artemis in Ephesus in the 3rd century before Common Era. And he also asked Lithuanian journalists not to mention my name, because in this manner my name could be, you know, recorded for history, as it was done with Herostratus. Lithuanian neo-Nazis organized many concerts in front of the empty place where the plaque was hanging. Let's take a look at them. So by playing this kind of music, they pretend to be a kind of intellectuals and present me as a barbarian, despite the fact that I have PhD from Paris and none of them had ever studied in a decent university. The neo-Nazis have even called a rock band called Dictatorship to play in front of the destroyed Nazi plaque. Let's take a look. So this rock band is actually called Dictatorship, and they play in order to re-establish the Noreika Nazi plaque. The Minister of Foreign Affairs of Lithuania, Gabrielius Landsbergis, made a statement that the plaque had to be re-established and that I had to be punished as hard as possible. So I have gotten 3 months of prison and I escape from the police. What surprised me was that the prosecutor of Lithuania was quoting the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Gabrielius Landsbergis, in my criminal trial in order to prove that I was a bad person. This is something strange. I wouldn't say that prosecutors should quote political leaders, especially neo-Nazi leaders. Neo-Nazi Gabrielius Landsbergis is a great-grandson of a Nazi leader from the World War II. His great-grandfather, Vytautas Landsbergis, was a minister of infrastructure in the Lithuanian Nazi government in 1941. And what is a ministry of infrastructure? All the ghettos of Jews, all the public institution under the name the Jewish concentration camp were under the administration of the Ministry of Infrastructure. So his great-grandfather was not just a Nazi, he was actually one of the leaders of Holocaust. This is not the only example when former Nazis get a huge political influence in Lithuania. Let's take Lithuanian president Valdas Adamkus. He was a Nazi soldier and he was actually murdering Belarusian civilians, Lithuanian civilians, of course, dark Lithuanian civilians during the World War II. He became a voluntary in the Hitler army. So he joined the Hitler military forces by conviction. And then he was elected president of Lithuania. This explains the Holocaust denial policy of Lithuania that continues for already 30 years. So everything what you have seen until now, you know, the reaction of the president, prime minister, minister of foreign affairs of Lithuania, their stupid mayor Šimašius, that's normal. The concerts, that's fine. That's what I have expected. However, what I haven't expected was that the bishop of the Roman Catholic Church, Bishop Kaunackas, you know, in Lithuania, but that he would gather hundreds and hundreds of people in front of the Nazi plaque at the day of its restoration in order to pray God to cut off my hands. Let's take a look at that. So this bishop actually prays to God to cut off my hands. That's that That prayer brings me joy because I am not Roman Catholic. I was in that church by mistake of my parents, but that was a huge mistake. And finally, let's take a look at the neo-Nazi gathering where they call to murder me. So this is a leader of an organization that is called Sąjūdis. Sąjūdis is the main organization that was running opposition to the democratic government of Mikhail Gorbachev in 1990. And he publicly calls to murder me. Now, actually, the period of Mikhail Gorbachev was the most democratic in the Lithuanian history. In the times of Gorbachev, there was free speech, there were no political prisoners. Right now in Lithuania, we have 14 political prisoners. We have a huge escape of so-called black population. So I have black hair. That's why I am considered as a part of a black minority in Lithuania. So the population of Lithuania dropped from 3.8 million in the times of Gorbachev to 2.5 million right now. So over a million people, 1,300,000 people escaped Lithuania because of racial and ethnic discrimination by the Lithuanian government. And it is happening in the European Union. In the European Union. For the European Union, Zimbabwe is much more interesting than Lithuania. Russia is more interesting than something that is happening just, you know, next to German border. So I actually do not regret anything. I am very happy to destroy that Nazi plaque. I am very happy. It brings me joy to see the concerts, the reaction of the President of Lithuania, Prime Minister, Minister of Foreign Affairs, all of them angry, and the Roman Catholic Church especially. It brings me joy. I am happy to see their reaction. I do not regret anything. Yes, I cannot return to Lithuania because I would be imprisoned for 3 months, but that's fine. I also call you to go to the OpenSea website where my NFT video, which is called Destruction of a Nazi Monument, is for sale. By buying this kind of NFTs, you actually make a contribution to a much wider worldwide direction of political protests. And this is very important. I actually believe that taking a sledgehammer and destroying a monument, getting 3 months of prison, escaping from the police, is something much more difficult than sitting in your room and making a GIF in 10 minutes. I do not say that those NFTs, those GIF NFTs have no value, but my sincere belief is that video NFTs that represent a political protest have a greater influence on our culture